Hi kids. Hi, Karl here. Bored out of my fucking mind. And so we just took the 110 out for a little rip. Just got her out of storage. Here she is. So got my Rico fucking mullet hat on. Let's run her through the gears. Yeah, so the one good thing that happened this week is we went to Adams Automotive in Cameron, Wisconsin, and picked up my missile, and we got her sitting in the frame rails here, and I might light her up for you here in a few minutes. And I know all you fucking bench racing idiots are gonna wanna know what it did on the dyno, and I'm gonna show you that shit, but I just have to fucking preempt this, is that, you fucking idiots out there with your virtual race cars and your virtual skill set. This is actually a real engine, and it went to a real dyno, and it wasn't me talking about my friend's engine or a friend's dyno. These are real numbers, and keep in mind, this is a cast iron intake, two barrel flat tappet camshaft, stamped steel rocker arm, and we'll fucking eat a crate engine right through the fucking 500 CFM butterflies and shit it right out my fucking steel Schoenfeld headers. So that's it. We're gonna talk some shit here now. And before you start fucking clicking away on the keyboard, just remember, before you even get started, you're probably gonna be called out by me as a fucking idiot. There's a couple of reasons why I chose Adams Automotive for my engine builder. One of them is Tom Nesbitt, late model Hall of Famer, living legend, and my childhood hero, always ran Adams Automotive power plants in his late model. And for you Ford guys, Tom also ran a lot of Adams Automotive Fords. Matter of fact, if you buy an engine today, whether it be a Chevrolet, Mopar, or a Ford, they all come Adams Automotive Blue, also known as Ford OEM Blue.
What's that? You need a couple more reasons? Oh, no problem.
Kevin Burdick, 30 feature wins in 2019. Also, your Wasota Superstock national champion, did it all with an Adams Automotive power plant between the frame rails. He won so many features in a row at his home track, they actually took a bounty to take him down. Kurt Myers backed it up by taking second national points, Wasota 100 winner, Punky Manor winner, and Red Clay Classic. Anybody would give their left nut just to win one of those shows. Fords, yeah, we fucking build those too. 16 nights in a B-mod for Buzzy Adams, and he won 13 shows with a Ford from Adams. Open motors for modifieds, no problem. Ward Emery, 2017 and 2018 national championship, and a 2019 runner-up.
Yeah, so those are just a few reasons why I would use Adams Automotive. Plus, it's not a fucking crate engine built in Mexico with a bunch of Chinese parts. It's all built with good USA shit right in fucking God's country in Wisconsin, Cameron. Next, we headed up to Pasco's dyno service in Cumberland, Wisconsin, where we put the old missile on the dyno and stretched out our valve springs and got some numbers. Enjoy. We'll be right back.
town, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found.
Okay, we got Connor here at the helm, and he's going to fire it up, put a little heat in it, and then we'll cut to a pull.
All the exhausts are on the screen. We'll make four. -80 degrees, and so we can see what the motor does with heat in it. So
let her eat.
Pull 4,000 RPM, 459.5 foot-pounds of torque, and 6,400 RPM is 432.1 horsepower. So, and it's just flat everywhere in between. So, doesn't drop off.
Well, there you go, kiddos. We shared the numbers. They're good, honest numbers, and I can't wait to start reading all the fucking comments from dipshits. And so, get on there, comment away. And we're gonna fire this thing up, let you hear it through its own fucking lungs here. Pasco's Dino, they bought me a 30 pack, a bushel of Bush for bringing the old Adams missile over. Appreciate that. So let's take a little listen to the new missile. Now you see what we did there. A couple of quick little snaps on the throttle, that's okay. I'm fucking down with that. Everybody's itching to go racing, and I fucking get a Woodrow down there when I hear a race engine too. But if you sit in the pits and rev the fucking shit out of your engine, and you're testing fucking valve springs and setting valve lash and checking float bowls and seeing if you can find a miss in your distributor system that doesn't fucking exist, you're an idiot. Nobody likes listening to that fucking shit. When we're just there to relax and do a little racing, there'll be plenty of time on the racetrack to beat the fuck out of your connecting rods and run your engine wide open with no oil temperature. Don't do that. Matter of fact, if people do that around me, I just walk over with a claw hammer and knock the fucking distributor cap off it and tell them, you know, how would you like to be shaken out of bed and put in a full fucking sprint in 1 second. So don't be an idiot. Nobody likes that shit. I do want to thank Rico for this fucking hat. This fucking thing is kick ass. So check out his website. He's got some fucking cool swag. You like my swag? It's cool. Here, I got some more too. Here's my newest Hot Karl. The old hats are Win 1B main. These actually say the Hot Karl chassis, backed up by the fucking Texas flag, baby. These are flex fit, snapback. It's called a hybrid. Does fucking two things at once. Makes you want to fucking drink beer and kick someone's ass all in the same breath. So, and the other thing that's going to be on my store now, by fucking popular demand, that, I don't know if you can see it. It's my own Hot Karl chassis, no crate engine sticker. So do a couple things tomorrow. Call your local engine builder. Tell them you're sorry you fucked them in the ass for buying crate engines. And then call your local sanctioning body and just tell them, hey, we're sick of riding cock and we don't like the way it tastes anymore. So we'd like an open engine, something affordable, makes about the same power as a crate, a little better. And you can actually work with a local engine builder. Thank you. Okay. So we end it here. That's what we do, huh?
and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. Bad. Bad.